Hello and welcome guys. In today's video, I'll be talking about Pascal's law. So what is Pascal's law? Pascal's law means that pressure applied at a point in a static fluid is equal in all directions. Now what is pressure? Okay, pressure, if I consider a fluid which is kept in a beaker, okay, and have fluid in it. Now if I consider a small area dA, okay, if I consider a small area dA and we have fluid all around the small area, okay. Now always the force will be exerted perpendicular to the direction of the surface area dA. Okay, so if I want to write a mathematical expression for that, how do I write? Okay, fluid at a point, what will be the pressure? Okay, the mathematical expression will be what? P will be equal to df by dA. Now if the pressure is, now in this case, in the first case, for case 1, this is pressure of a fluid at a point. Now if the pressure is uniformly distributed all around the area, if the pressure is uniformly distributed, what will be the pressure? Pressure will be force by area, and the SI unit will be Newton per meter square. Okay, now we are going to talk about the pressure variation of a fluid at rest. So to prove this equation, we need to derive it. Now how do we derive it? If I consider a fluid in a beaker, which is filled in a beaker, and I have a small fluid element having area A, B, C, D, okay, having area dA, and the height of the fluid element will be delta Z, okay, and the height, the distance of the fluid element from the surface, I will consider it as Z. Okay, now we have a force from the top as well as from the down direction. What is the force from the up direction? The force exerted on AB will be what? Will be, we know that pressure is force by area. So force will be pressure into area. So what is pressure here? Pressure will be dp into A. Okay, why dp? Because it is a, we are considering only a small area. Okay, AB. Now what is the pressure on, what will be the force on DC? The force on DC will be what? It will be P plus dou P by dou Z into delta Z into area. Okay, into delta A. Here it will be delta A because it's a small area. Okay, now we are going to prove this. How do we prove this equation? We know that we discuss now that the force, the pressure on the force on AB and as well as the force on DC. Okay, now we have to consider another scenario of weight of the, how much is the weight of the fluid element. So weight of the fluid element, it is how much weight of the fluid element? We know that weight is mass into, mass of what? Mass of the fluid element into the acceleration due to gravity. Now what is mass? Mass will be, can be written as density into volume. So density into volume into g. So what is density here? So density will be delta into dou into, what is v? volume. Volume will be what? Delta A into delta Z into G. Okay. So now the force on AB, I'm just writing it for so that you can easily see it. Force on AB will be what? DP into delta A, and force on CD will be P plus dou P by dou Z into delta Z into delta A. Okay, so now we are adding equation 1 plus 2 plus 3. So what do we get? Weight of the fluid element is what? Rho into delta A into delta Z into G plus P into delta A okay. Now to note that since we have a fluid element in the upward direction and we have a force in the upward and downward direction, so to distinguish that we have a force in the from up to downward direction, we'll put as positive sign, and for down from the down direction to the up direction, the force will be, you can take it as negative, so minus P plus dou P by dou Z into delta Z. Okay, sorry, this is into delta A. Okay, into delta A will be equal to 0. Now, simplifying all this, okay, what do we get after simplification? We get rho into delta A into delta Z into G plus P delta A minus P delta A minus dou P by dou Z into delta A will be equal to 0. Now you can cancel these two terms. Okay, now what do we get after this? Okay, we get, now I'll bring this term to the right hand side so that I can put it as positive sign, dou P by dou Z into delta Z into delta A is equal to rho into delta A into delta Z into G. Okay, so these two terms can also be cancelled, right? Okay, so what do we get in the end? Dou P by dou Z is equal to rho G. So what is rho G? Rho G is nothing but the specific weight. Okay, so this equation, okay, from this equation we can say that what? The rate of increase in pressure in the vertical direction is equal to the weight density of the fluid element. Okay, so the increase in pressure is equal to the what? Specific weight of the fluid element at that point. Okay, so this is nothing but what? Hydrostatic law. So P is equal to, we can write after I'll simplify more, P is equal to rho G into what? DZ, and I integrate these two, so what do I get in the end? P equal to rho GZ. So this is what? Hydrostatic law. Okay, so I hope this derivation is clear for you. It's a simple derivation, but it is very important too. Okay, if you have any doubts regarding this topic, feel free to comment in the comment section. Thank you.